How are you, Eddie?
Do we do the Hanuman breath today? Is it part of the curriculum or?
No, Hanuman breath I will not include here because then it'll just take too much time, number one. And the focus here is, of course, the Swaskosh Shuddhi Kriya. For the Hanuman master breath, are you on Facebook, Arunabji?
Yeah, I'm there on Facebook.
So if you do a search on Hanuman master breath on the Google, on the Facebook groups,
okay,
you'll find it.
Okay.
And once you get there, okay, look for the videos on Hanuman master breath, or look for the video on Hanuman master breath along with the explanatory piece. They're together.
Okay.
That'll bring you a lot of clarity on how to do it. Okay. And it's a very powerful method.
Okay.
Which works like a charm to clear pains, aches, etc. It's worked with me for fibromyalgia, for sciatica, and backaches, etc.
Okay.
It's a powerful technique. Addy, how are you doing?
Very good, very good.
And okay, you? So I'm good, thanks. I had some root canal treatment done yesterday.
Uh-oh.
So I was a little feverish today morning. I don't know whether it's connected with that or not, but it's the first time I've had anything to do with my teeth, basically, except when I was maybe younger, and then maybe some fillings then or something, but yeah, nothing in the last few decades. So I don't know whether this fever came on because of that, but anyway, it's time, and I don't see too many people, so I don't know. Well, it's 31, so maybe they'll join in a few minutes.
Yeah.
All right. So let's do 3 ohms, and then we'll start. Slow, deep breath. The more you learn to keep your belly relaxed, more and more, the deeper the level of relaxation in the belly, the better results you get with everything, all your breath work and so on. Most of us are aware of our breath moving down. So basically what we feel about the breath is it comes from the nose, goes into the lungs, and then some people are aware that it goes a little deeper. But there are also some who understand that the breath is actually, or the energy meridians actually connect all the way from Sahasrara to the Mooladhara. Breath is able to access these meridians in some way. In some way, when you breathe, you will, if you think of it from the yoga point of view, panchakoshas, annamay kosh, pranamay kosh, manomay kosh, vijnanamay kosh, and the anandamay kosh, the 5 different koshas or sheaths or bodies. Physical body is what it is. We all know there's a nose, this is what we breathe through. But there is a sukshma sharir. If you want to combine the others, you know, the pranamay, manomay, etc., think of them as the sukshma sharir, the subtle body. In the subtle body, the breath or the pathways of energy do not have to work through the nose, etc. You can actually channelize energy through the Sahasrara all the way down towards the Mooladhara. Here, Ida, Pingala, Sushumna, this is something everybody talks of. I bring people's attention to what I see as the Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh nadis, and they run all the way down from the Sahasrara to the Mooladhara. Why am I talking about this here? If you remember just now, I said, keep your belly relaxed. So belly, there is a channel which I call I call it the Brahma channel. You may not find corresponding information about this with this name. Maybe others may have called it by some other name. I don't know. But there's this nadi, or there's this channel that seems to run. You may not feel it so clearly down this part, but you'll certainly feel it very clearly, maybe from the heart region or from the navel region. And it feels as if it's along the surface of the body. Very, very far. I'll mute it. Sorry. Yeah, so if you wish to speak, you can unmute. So this, the thing that runs along the surface of the body, very, very powerful channel. If you learn to keep it relaxed, it'll make a huge difference in many aspects of your life. It's just that, you know, it came to my mind, so I said, let me share it with you. Anyway, so the three techniques that we are going to do here in the Swaskosh Shuddhi Kriya, two you've already done, the huffing technique and the complete yogic breath. We'll just go over it very quickly. In the huffing technique, first, you take a full deep breath and you allow the huff to start from the base of the spine, the tailbone, move upwards, up along the spine. As this movement starts, it starts clearing something along the Sushumna. As it begins to clear, you begin to access the Sushumna a little more effectively, a little deeper. As the Sushumna comes into your awareness, or if it starts working, the cleansing starts. It starts impacting all aspects of your being, life, experiences, and so on. Yeah. So that is the role of the Sushumna. When we do the huffing technique, move it up this way. First, it does a very gentle kind of a cleansing. Then when you do the when you do the Krishna's flute maneuver and you do the squeezes at the Muladhara and higher, if you remember, the visualization that I referred to was the milking, but you're milking upwards as if you're milking, you know, along your Sushumna. Why do we call it milking? Because the movement is somewhat similar. The idea is to squeeze anything that is there, push it up along the Sushumna and get it out of your system. You've tried it. Hopefully you've seen some effect. I don't know. It's still very early days, so it's hard to say. But the more you're able to access your Sushumna, the better results you'll get in many, many different aspects of your life. In every aspect of your life, I could say that. So you did the squeezing. Let's do a few squeezes with the huffing technique, just to remind ourselves how we've done it. Have you done it all today on your own? Did you? No. Arunab, did you do it on your own? Shekhavaji? No. Chali, abhi kar lete thoda sa. Huffing, or let's do one or two rounds of huffing technique, pushing the breath up the spine. Okay, very good. Excellent. Let's push the breath up the spine. Take a slow, full, deep breath. Belly relaxed. And go. Relax the belly. Again, huff. Relax the belly. Repeat. One more time if you can. In breath. See if something needs to come out. You may feel some sensation in the throat. You may feel a little, some movement, some kind of movement. Expel whatever needs to be expelled. Yeah, very good. Also notice the sound that comes to your awareness from the lungs, etc. It's a sign, if there is a sound coming from the lung area, it's a sign that there is some blockage somewhere, or there is some phlegm build up somewhere. When you do the huff, I didn't do the second part of this technique, but I'll just introduce a little bit of it just in case you need to do it. So when you do this huff, and if you find that there is a sound coming from a certain area, you do an internal squeeze in that area. So supposing you find as if there is some sound, say in this lower part of the right lung, maybe somewhere here. You go, when you do the huff again, try to internally squeeze here. Add a little pressure here, gentle at first. And then of course you can add it, you can increase it. So this is what you do. And this is just an extra way to squeeze anything out of the lungs that might, you know, might be causing the sound or the congestion and so on. Then let's do the Krishna's flute maneuver with the huffing technique. Slow, full deep breath. Allow the first huff. If you like, you can squeeze. Otherwise, you can start the squeeze with the second one. Relax your belly. Squeeze at the muladhar. Along the spine. Relax. Muladhar, Swadhisthan. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And maybe higher.
सर ये जैसे कल आपने डिस्कस किया था आपने जैसे पूछा था कि आपको जो ये कृष्ण फ्लूट मैनुअल में जो एक्सेलरेशन करना है वो माउथ से नहीं करना खाली नोज से ही करना है
हफिंग टेक्निक में तो माउथ है ना
हाँ माउथ है हफिंग में तो
हफिंग टेक्निक में तो माउथ इज द वन दैट वी आर यूजिंग सो इन द हफिंग टेक्निक वी विल यूज द माउथ इन द कंप्लीट योगिक ब्रेथ
ओके
section, there is no use of the mouth. We breathe through the nose, we exhale through the nose. So there is no need to use the mouth again.
Krishna's flute manual is just huffing.
Krishna's flute maneuver is used for all the different techniques. In the huffing technique, the Krishna's flute maneuver is used with the huff. The Krishna's flute maneuver is not how you breathe out. It's about how you squeeze along the the spine or along the sushumna. That is the Krishna's flute maneuver. Remember the visualization, Krishna's flute, 7 holes, 7 chakras along the spine.
परसों मैंने किया था तो हफिंग के साथ ही किया था पर कल मेरे ऐसे समझ में आया कि आपने उसके माउथ के लिए मना किया.
When you do the huffing technique, Krishna's flute maneuver is as the huffing technique is. We are not changing the huffing technique. We are doing the Krishna's flute maneuver. Maneuver is a way of doing something. Na? Maneuver. To operate. How would you use the word maneuver? How would you describe the word maneuver? System of doing something. A movement. Okay. Yeah. So that is how. Sorry, Adi.
No, absolutely. I would agree. It's kind of an organized way of doing something.
It's an organized way of doing something. Very good. So this is what you do with your huffing technique. You use the Krishna's flute maneuver to breathe out in a certain way. That's all. Huff to phir bhi huff hai. Second part was the complete yogic breath. In the complete yogic breath, you allow a full breath. And then when you exhale, allow the first exhale to go out with the second exhale. Squeeze or a little, you know, tightening or a milking movement along the sushumna. Starting at the muladhara swadhisthan. For people who cannot do more than a few out breaths, they can actually do muladhara swadhisthan together. And then muladhara swadhisthan, manipura, anahata. So based on how, listen to your body. But try to get the full momentum so that the effect, the results are good. What are the results we are looking for here? Cleansing. That's all we are looking for. We are trying to clear the pathway because the more the sushumna is cleansed or cleared, the easier it will be for the rest of the cleansing to happen. Please understand this. The sushumna, think of the sushumna as the main drain channel. It may also be the main power supply, but it is also the main drainage system in a sense. So all the 72,000 nadis, estimated 72,000 nadis, whatever needs to be expelled from those nadis needs to move out through the sushumna. For you, for anybody on the adhyatmic path, until such time as the sushumna is opened and active, everything else is only drama. there is not going to be any effect. Because how is the transformation going to come? The transformation has to come through whatever the processes in the body are. The chakras have to be cleansed. When the chakras are cleansed, it has an impact on the mind, intellect, etc. So all of it is interconnected. All of it is interconnected, but there is this physical connection which helps you to clear out whatever is remaining there, clogged there, and so on. Once you cleanse it, see, ab mazey ki cheez dekhe in the yogic system. If you are body conscious, if you are physical or body conscious, your actions, your attention, your mind, your energy is used up here, connected with the body. If you become mind conscious, you become involved with the mind and the games of the mind. Now, mind is a very powerful thing. Unfortunately, for most, the mind works as an enemy rather than a friend. That's a problem. So if the mind is overactive, but if there is any kind of emotional imbalance for any reason, if there is any kind of emotional imbalance, or if the ego is very, very strongly present, what does the ego do? Ego identifies oneself with a limited being. This body, this me, or you know, whatever my limitations are. That is what the ego is about. But it's not the presence of the ego that brings life. It's the presence of Atma which brings life into the body. That is the real self. So think of that as the sun. When the sun is there, there is a shadow. The shadow is the ego. The moment Atma leaves the ego, ego is gone. It can't do anything. So ego is just like a shadow that comes into play when the sun of Atma is there. Anyway, let's not get into that. Let's come back to our Swaskosh Shuddhi Kriya. So work on your Sushumna. Squeeze it upwards with the Muladhar, Swadhisthan, and so on. Once again, full deep breath. And go. Pay attention to the sound. Yeah. This coughing, something needs to come out. Throw it out. Very good. Like Shekhavaji did. What I do is I keep a handkerchief. I clear my throat like this. And out. So whatever needs to come out can come out. And it's very easy to dispose of that. So just put a little tissue paper in this container and it's easy to dispose.
I have kept container, sir.
You kept a container, yeah. So if you put a little tissue paper there, it'll be easy to clean the container. Now, second part was the complete yogic breath. What do we do in the complete yogic breath? Anybody remember?
You will exhale from the nose and inhale from the nose.
That is, exhale comes later. First the inhale. What kind of inhale?
We will inhale from the nose and then first, then we exhale from the nose and squeeze the...
Yes. But the first, yes, but the first part is you have to fill your whole body with breath. Yes. You have to collect the breath as low as possible. If your breath can go to the pelvic area, let the breath go to that area. Fill it up all the way up to the shoulders. When you filled your whole body with the breath, allow the exhale to start at the Muladhar, at the tailbone, or the lowest portion, whichever comes into your experience, wherever the lowest portion is, allow the exhale to start over there. Clear? Clear? Hello?
Yes.
Are we clear? Very good. Okay. So this is the first part of the complete yogic breath. And what is the second part? The Krishna's flute maneuver, right? The Krishna's flute maneuver. What do you do in the Krishna's flute maneuver? Remember?
Squeezing.
Yeah, squeeze up. Like milking the cow. but milking the cow, milking the sushumna upwards, cleansing it.
Milking okay. cow to downwards, sir.
But we are doing the milking the sushumna upwards.
Yes.
That is only itna little mat hoye. That is only to create a visualization so you understand how the movement is. In milking the cow, what is the movement? You hold the udder and you pull downwards. Hai na? Isko taan, aise taante hai. Pull kare. Think of this as the udder. You will pull like this. You will pull it down like this. Right? That is how you take out the milk. Right? Here in the Sushumna, it's done in a subtle way. You are moving it up like this. Or you're moving up like this. Pushing it up, just pushing it up. Do the complete yogic breath. Take a full deep breath. Allow the exhale from the lowest portion. When it's all gone, relax your belly and continue to allow the exhale up the spine. One more time. Breathe in. Wait a moment. Allow the exhale from the lowest point. Ideally, tailbone. And it's all gone. Relax your belly. Wait a moment. Continue. Again. One more time. So with these 3-4 repetitions, the movement starts up along the spine. You are able to start clearing whatever is there in the Sushumna. Thoda ba, it's a slow process, but it's very powerful. It's very effective. Now, I'll tell you something very interesting that happens. When the Sushumna begins to clear, begins to get cleansed, it impacts all the 5 sense organs directly. So it will impact, for example, the clarity of your vision, how good your eyes are, how well they function. It'll affect that. It'll affect the quality of the sound of your voice. Your voice will change a lot. Your voice will begin to acquire a nice ring to it, if I can call it that, a nice tone to it. So you will notice people, Sadhguru is a great guy, but Sadhguru, if you notice the quality of his voice, there's a huge richness to the quality of his voice. Osho, everyone must have heard Osho. Observe the quality of the sound of their voice. There's something special about their voice. So this is a process that starts when your Sushumna starts getting cleansed. And of course, there are numerous other benefits that come along the way. Many other benefits. Your skin starts to glow. And so on. Anyway, so once again, take a slow, full, deep breath. And this time, allow the Krishna's flute maneuver with the complete yogic breath. Exhale. Okay, very good. Shekhavajji ko to bahut laab ho raha hai because I can see that you are expelling a lot of phlegm. That's very good. The more you are able to throw out, the better you will breathe. The better you will breathe, the better you will feel. It'll improve every aspect of your life. Adi, you're also throwing out a little phlegm if I'm not wrong. Okay, excellent. Wonderful. I don't know about the others because I can't see them. What about Deepa Shri, Nokia 5.1 Plus? That's the name I see. Soma Basu.
Sir, in this yogic breath technique, I'm not able to spell out anything, but
doesn't matter.
Okay.
If your body does not have too much phlegm, you will not throw it out. So okay. It doesn't matter.
Okay. However, and one more thing, when we are exhaling, like 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 in that movement, so that time our belly is squeezing inside, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Yeah. So when you do the squeeze, your belly tends to push inwards. After that, you relax your belly. When you relax your belly, it will tend to move outwards.
Yes.
So that now you have leverage. You can do the push once again. So to get that leverage, you need to relax the belly. So that's why I keep saying between the squeezes, relax your belly. Relax your belly. Because you are able to get the leverage then to do the next squeeze. Clear?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
What about Mandira, Soma, Nokia 5.1? Ho raha achhe se ho raha aapka? Vijay ji, namaste. Shekhavaji, aapka achha kaap nikala. So this is the complete yogic breath. And I think you are clear about this. We'll move on to our third part. Ready? Any questions so far? Huffing technique, complete yogic breath. Are we clear, everyone? Give me a thumbs up or whatever. Okay, great. Yeah, wonderful. So now the third is the anulom vilom. Anulom vilom with the Swaskosh Shuddhi Kriya elements. We begin. See, take these first two fingers to the base of the thumb. And now this is what you see on the outside. So the thumb goes to the right nostril. And the ring finger goes to the left nostril. If one is pressed, the other is open. If the other is pressed, the one is open. So it moves easily. It switches easily. Are we clear? Ek bar try this a few times.
Sir, is some suggest that these fingers should be touched to the third eye chakra?
Yes, yeah. Yes, some do that also. So, uske liye kya karte hain ispe? This is how the first two fingers, they put it here. And then with the ring and the thumb, they do. It's a more advanced technique. You can do it if you're more comfortable with that. But for most people, this suffices. You know, your two fingers on the base of your thumb, right, the thumb at the right nostril and the ring finger at the left. It's easier. If you do it here, it'll need a little more practice. This Ajna is a very interesting chakra. It's a very interesting chakra. It's a very powerful part of your physiology.
Pituitary
gland. Yes. So the activation can be done through a little bit of manipulation here. Yes. But there is also a lot of inner work that needs to be done. Also, it is connected with your sinus, etc. If the sinuses are blocked, they have to be cleared. They have to be cleansed. Otherwise, it will interfere with the activity of the Ajna, obviously. So, if you want to do it, no problem. No issues at all. So, once again, first you begin by pressing the right nostril and breathing out gently. Comfortable, easy breath. Breathe out. When you've had a good breath out, emptied, inhale with the left. Same. So remember the first part. You begin first by exhaling with the left, the ira. First exhale, then inhale. This is the basic principle that you have to maintain.
Please, first, one more repeat time. Repeat.
First you will exhale, then you will inhale. That the nostril through which you exhale, that is the nostril through which you inhale. So first exhale, then inhale. Just remember this. So you blocking the right, first exhale with the left, and then inhale with the left. Right? Clear? Clear? Deepashri, clear?
Yes.
And then what will you do? Inhale with the left, close the left. Exhale with the right. inhale with the right, close the right, exhale with the left.
Sir, one question.
Yes.
Is there any count or time to inhale or exhale?
So that is a part of pranayama technique. If somebody wishes to employ that later, you can do that. No problem. But here, what is our goal here? Our goal here is to cleanse the nadis and the lungs. So therefore, the focus is not on counting how long we hold the breath. That is not the important thing here. Or how many counts we
have. A deep breath and deep exhalation and deep inhalation?
Yeah. Fuller inhale, fuller exhale.
Okay.
Fuller your exhale and inhales are, the better results you will get. Why? Because every time you get a fuller inhale or exhale, you are able to empty out and throw out more of the stuff that needs to be thrown out. When there is more of this stuff which is not needed that is thrown out, there is space for fresher stuff. What is the fresher stuff? Prana energy. Once the prana energy comes here, it works its way through the body. We need to expel whatever needs to go out. And then we allow as much of that as possible so that there is space for new prana energy to come into the body. So start by first blocking the right, exhaling.
One question.
Yes, please.
So when you inhale, so you take the breath down to the perineum, to the muladhara?
If you can, yes.
If you can.
Okay. If you can. Now, since everyone has not learned techniques connected with that, I don't mention it here.
Okay. But you can actually do that. You can take the breath down there and you can exhale also from down there.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Okay. And if you go deeper into breath work and understand and start to capitalize on the power of the breath, capitalize on the power of the breath means you use the techniques of pranayama or breath work to enhance whatever is there in your body. If your energy is being circulated better, what does it mean? It passes through all your chakras, cleansing them along the way, and then a new cycle of life begins. See, all of us go through life. At some point of time, we make some mistakes. At least I made a lot of mistakes, like smoking crazy amounts of cigarettes and stuff, for example, late nights, and loads of other nonsense. You know, I've done it all. So, but it's only through your wrongs that you learn how to right them. Anyway, so if you wish to capitalize on the power of your breath and the energy system, see, remember one thing. Earlier, what were we talking about? The body consciousness, mind, or the mental body, and so on. It is your prana body, pranamaya kosh, which can create a straight bridge to the vijnanamaya kosh. If anyone is more active in the physical or in the mental, if you've heard Sadhguru, one of his meditations is about, I'm not the body, I'm not the mind. Because most people are stuck with either of these. Either they identify too much with the body or they identify too much with their minds. And both have their own issues and their problems and so on. So if you're next, if you're able to jump straight into your intelligence body or knowledge body, your vijnanamaya kosh, your breath can help you to do that. So you can think of your pranamaya kosh as a leap, as a means to leapfrog into the vijnanamaya kosh. That means you stop being played by your physical anamaya kosh and by your mental body so much. How does the physical body control you? You want to enjoy the physical pleasures, for example. You want to enjoy a certain amount of rest or a lot of rest, for example. Laziness, for example. Your body cannot bear, it looks for food, for example. It overeats, for example. Or indulges in sex too much, for example. It's not able to bear too much of, heat or cold. Or even a small variation. So you'll find many people, temperature drops by three degrees and they start feeling very cold. Temperature rises by three degrees and they want air conditioning. Why this lack of tolerance? The body should be able to easily tolerate, you know, a difference of 10-15 degrees without any problem. If the ambient temperature, let's see, in your city is say about 20 degrees, and if it goes up to 30, you shouldn't lose your mind over that. If it drops to maybe 15, it shouldn't be like you're feeling extremely cold. If it drops to 10, maybe you'll feel a little colder. But up to 15 degrees, so there shouldn't be too much of a problem. Your body should be able to normally accept that much of a variation without too much of an impact. Similarly, why this over-dependence on food and so on? So this is about the body consciousness. In the mind, most of us, the mind is always working. Something happened in the past, some worries connected with the future and so on. Mind is over there. It's playing its own games. So when this is what is happening with our life, with our life's energies, something is not right. We are not being able to fulfill ourselves or to reach our highest potential. If your pranamaya body is able to access the intelligent, the knowledge body, the vijnanamaya kosh faster, that means clarity will come into your life. What does vijnanamaya kosh bring you? It brings you clarity. It brings you insights. What is insight? You see things better. You just understand. It's like, you know, inside you're able to access certain pieces of knowledge or certain kinds of knowledge. Anyway, so that is what it is. That's what the pranamaya kosh is about. So as you work your energy body, and if you're able to access your vijnanamaya kosh faster, you stand to gain. I'm sorry I gave such a long explanation, but I think you are clearer with that, Arunabji.
Thank you.
Okay. Right. So now let's continue with our anulom vilom with the Swaskosh elements. Exhale with the left. Keep your belly very relaxed. Exhale with the left. Then take a full breath in. Easy breath. Block the left. Exhale with the right. All gone. Inhale with the right. Block the right. Exhale with the left. So this is the basic anulom vilom. This is the basic anulom vilom. How do you use the Swaskosh elements with the anulom vilom now? See, you block the right, allow the first exhale. All gone. Wait a moment. A second exhale. Relax your belly. A second exhale. Relax your belly. A third exhale. Inhale with the left. Block the left. Exhale with the right. When it's all gone, relax your belly. Exhale some more. Once again. Inhale with the right. Block the right. Exhale with the left. All gone. Wait a moment. Relax the belly. Exhale some more. Relax the belly. Exhale some more. So this is the Swaskosh element. So this is the first part of the Swaskosh. Just a repeat exhale or number of exhales without inhalation. Remember, this is what we did in the huffing technique. This is what we did in the complete yogi breath. We do the same thing here, but we do it with the anulom vilom. So now this is the first part. And then you do the whole thing, say five times. 5 cycles of inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Repeat exhales. Inhale. Repeat exhales again. Inhale. This is the cycle. You do 5 of these. And now the most important part, which is the Krishna's flute maneuver with the Anulom Vilom technique. Anulom Vilom is also variously called the Nadi Shodhan.
Rajesh ji.
Haji.
Before you move to the next Krishna's flute, I just wanted two small clarifications. One is that after you have taken the full breath in, do you stay for few seconds or immediately do the breath out?
Very good, very good. If you are able to hold it for a second or 2 seconds, you can do it. I welcome it. I encourage it. But I don't talk about it because, like I said earlier, here the focus is on cleansing the lungs.
Okay.
So the more we are able to expel, the better will be the cleansing effect.
Okay.
So therefore, I don't say ki aap hold the breath. You can hold it for a second or 2 seconds. It doesn't matter. It's good only. No harm in that. So if you can build that into your practice, by all means do it. Now, let's come to
second clarification.
Yeah.
The duration of the breathing in and the duration of the breathing out.
No. Here the focus is not on that. That is a pranayam technique that is often used and often considered very important as well. But we are not focused on that. Our focus is on cleansing.
Exhale.
So that as much stuff can be thrown out, the better.
Okay, I got it.
So now let's start with
one question just to add to that. So yes, after inhalation, you can hold for a second or two. And after exhalation, can I hold for a second or two?
Certainly. Okay. It won't harm you.
Okay.
So there's no problem. Since you are combining, you know, what is called generally considered a deeper part of pranayam. So it's a good thing. No harm with that.
And so with this exhale, it will be very forcefully or smoothly exhale.
I will explain that. Okay. Very good, Deepashi, that you asked this question. So far, whatever we have done, if you remember the first day, I said, listen to your body. When you start with these techniques, it's always best to go slow. Do not use too much pressure. Do not use too much force for now. Be gentle. Let the channels start to open first. Let the channels to begin to cleanse first. Then, if you feel your body can handle a little extra pressure, a little more intensity, by all means do it. You'll get very good results. But please, for heaven's sake, do not try too much of that at the very beginning. Go easy.
Okay, thank you.
And if you share this, Deepashiji, are you from S-VYASA by any chance?
Yes, actually.
Okay, so that means you are connected with yoga, etc. So please be careful that you don't tell any of your participants or anybody who learns from you to add pressure in the beginning. In the beginning, just go very easy, very simple. Let the process start. Let the cleansing begin. Once it goes deeper, then by all means, add a little more pressure, depending on an individual's state of health and so on.
Okay,
let's start again. Fingers to the base of the thumb. The right nostril is blocked. Exhale with the left. Now, when you do the exhale, allow the first exhale. With the second exhale, squeeze at the Muladhara. Relax Muladhara and Swadhisthana. Relax. 1, 2, 3. Relax. 1, 2, 3, 4. Relax. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In. Block the left, out with the right. All gone. Relax the belly. Squeeze 1. Relax. One, two. Relax. One, two, three. Relax. One, two, three, four. Relax. One, two, five. In. Block the right, out with the left. All gone. Squeeze one. Relax. One, two. Relax. One, two, three. Relax. One, two, four. Relax. One, two, five. In. Block the left, out with the right. All gone. Relax. Squeeze one. One, two. One, two, three. One, two, three, four. One, two, five. In with the right. Block the right, out with the left. All gone. Squeeze one. One, two. One, two, three. One, two, three, four. One, two, five. In. Do you notice an improvement in the quality of your breath immediately? You can see your breath feels lighter. Addy, I can see you nodding. Yes. Immediate improvement in the quality of your breath. Your breath feels so much lighter. Arunabji, can you feel it? Yeah, great, wonderful. Vijayji, can you feel the change in the quality of the breath?
I think to me it appears that because you are forcing breath out,
yes,
so it's creating the reverse of breathing in.
Okay, but does your breath feel lighter?
Yeah, it becomes lighter because you have breathed out more.
Yeah, but we've been breathing out more even in the huffing technique. But yeah, it is after this that your breath feels especially light. If it feels, yes. If it doesn't, yeah, doesn't matter.
Yeah, I have felt that. But yeah. I am connecting it that because when you are breathing out in the stages after the first breath out continuous, then the cell and the lungs and all those are hungry for more.
No, but you've done this. You've done this in the huffing technique, in the complete yogic breath also.
But I think this one is better.
This feels the change in the quality of breath, the clarity, the ease is immediate.
That is
the power.
Now, I agree.
This is something I recommend that people should do on a regular basis. If you ever catch a cough, cold, etc., and your condition, there is a congestion, etc., then go through all the stages. Do the huffing technique, the two parts, complete yogic breath. For colds, I have told you, the complete yogic breath itself is a very powerful technique. At least that blockage, you know, that sense that the nose is blocked, that will go away. You'll be able to breathe better. You'll be able to breathe much easier. But here, what you see is, we did what? Three cycles of the Anulom Vilom with the Krishna's flute maneuver. And you see immediately a huge improvement in the quality of your breath. Yes. I think you've noticed that. Yes. Okay, let me see. Put your hands up or your thumbs up if you've seen a remarkable improvement in the quality of your breath. Thank you, Arunabji. Yeah. Yeah, thank you, Vijayji. Deepashiji has got a finger.
I have some improvement, not remarkable, but
okay. What about the others? Sameer Jahmatia ji, thank you. Very good. Yeah. So, you know, most of you have felt the immediate change in the quality of your breath.
On the upper side.
Sorry?
I am unable to squeeze the solar and...
Okay. It'll happen, Shekhavaji. Good time.
Muldara, I can basic. And yeah, so...
Yeah, but with time, you'll be able to manage that. So let's do a few rounds once again. Block the right. Exhale with the left. All gone. Relax the belly. Squeeze one. Then one, two. One, two, three. One, two, three, four. One, two, five. In. Block the left, out with the right. One. One, two. One, two, three. One, two, three, four. One, two, five. In with the right. Block the right, out with the left. Relax. Squeeze one. Krishna's flute, one, two. Krishna's flute, one, two, three. One, two, three, four. One, two, five. In. Block the left, out with the right. All gone. Relax the belly. Squeeze one. One, two. One, two, three. One, two, three, four. One, two, five. In. Block the right, out with the left. Relax, squeeze one. One, two. One, two, three. One, two, three, four. One, two, five. In. And enjoy that improved breath. Immediately better, easier, smoother, lighter. Do this every day, and obviously your breathing will improve, but more importantly, it'll start acting on your sushumna very, very fast. The faster your sushumna cleanses, the better results you will get. Everyone, try it on your own without me prompting you, so that you understand the technique a little better. Please do it on your own. Notice, see if you have any questions. Ask me the questions if you have any.
Okay, so for me, in the huffing technique and the yogic breath, the phlegm did not come out. Okay. But in the anulom vilom, I think my nose was clearing out a lot. So there was blockage inside, but I mean, I had to keep blowing. Okay. So, yeah.
Okay, yeah. So this is the liquidish stuff, is it?
I think both.
A little bit of.
And something deep thicker. Inside was also coming out. So, blockage in the passage.
So, I think Jal Niti will help you a lot if that is the case. Very nice, but I'm glad. And then you can see the improvement in the quality of your breath.
Yeah, the breath feels like.
Sorry. Haan, Shikabaji.
Sir, alternative to Jal Niti, Neso Vas karke aata hai, jo matlab usko एक प्लास्टिक बोतल है उसमें स्लाइम
ओके देयर यू गो आई डोंट नो बट आई थिंक इट विल बी मोर इजीली अवेलेबल वेयर यू आर इज इट अवेलेबल एवरीवेयर शिकाबजी नेजो वॉश ओके एंड इसका व्यवहार कैसे होता है बस ऐसे रख के ऐसे स्क्वीज करेंगे
और वो जो स्लाइम जाएगा
पाएगा अच्छा तो हेड को टिल्ट भी नहीं करना पड़ेगा
नहीं आपको हल्का सा टिल्ट करना पड़ेगा This you can use this.
Okay.
It is better.
Okay. और इसका जो पानी होता
है स्लाइन के लिए वैसे तो नॉर्मल स्लाइन अपने यूज कर सकते हैं नहीं तो इसका पैकेट से आते हैं उनको लूक वार्म वाटर में मिक्स करके यहाँ तक फिल करके उसको मतलब प्रेस करेंगे और आपका धीरे धीरे है उस जल नेति से इट इज बेटर
नेजो वॉश
Nezovas.
ये Amazon में मिलता है क्या
हाँ सर सब सिप्ला कंपनी का कहीं मेडिकल स्टोर पर मिल जाए किसी
ओके ग्रेट वेरी गुड एडवाइस थैंक यू सो मच शिकावत जी आई विल डेफिनेटली ट्राई
एंड सिंपलर
आई विल डेफिनेटली ट्राई सो आई थिंक दैट्स अ वंडरफुल एडवाइस फ्रॉम शिकावत जी एवरीबॉडी कैन टेक नोट एंड टेक एडवांटेज एज वेल
Nezovas.
हाँ Nezovas. वेरी नाइस थैंक यू
This can be used for the sinus and all that cleaning.
So Arunabji, there you go. Beautiful suggestion from Dr. Shekhamit.
I have a normal neti, the classic one, which I have.
I know. Wo to usko to use kariye, no problem. Yeah. If it's a copper, if it's a copper thing,
copper hai, aapko usse use karte hai
better. Wo to khair bahut acha hai. But traveling वगैरह में, supposing it's too heavy to carry around, etc., maybe something like this.
This is a portable and you can carry it.
Okay, so I'll have to leave in a couple of minutes. So just wanted to conclude. So so we do the anulom vilom normally, and then we do the anulom vilom with the Krishna flute maneuver.
No. We do the anulom vilom with the swaskosh elements. What is the swaskosh element? You allow multiple exhales without the in-breath.
Okay.
So exhale. Wait a moment. Exhale some more.
Okay.
Wait a little. Exhale some more.
But you don't squeeze the Mooladhara, etc.
No. For initially, you don't. You just get the momentum going. That whatever preparation has to be done. Priming has to be done. Think of it as, you know, you're priming the system so that the Krishna's flute maneuver is a little more intense. It's a little more, you know, targeting.
Okay.
And it gives you, it brings you results immediately. Okay. So you're just creating conditions so that the Krishna's flute maneuver can happen easily or with greater ease.
That's okay. All. Okay. Okay. So, yeah. So
basically, yeah, this is what. So just practice on your own again. See if you have a question. Anybody? Yeah. Everyone, please do this. Practice on your own.
So I'll do this thing and I'll watch the video on the Hanuman Master Breath. And maybe I'll connect with you some other time over WhatsApp.
Sure. Thank you. Most welcome.
Thank you. Namaste.
Thank you.
Yeah, abhi hai. Aap log practice kari. Ye Krishna's flute maneuver. Unko jana tha, to he asked to go. Do the Krishna's flute maneuver with the Nadi Shodhan or the Anulom Vilom. See the effect.
Sir, I want to ask one thing.
Ji, Deepashi ji.
Yes, like I have some nose blockage problem. Many times I am facing that. So, is that time I can practice this kriya? It be suggestible?
So if after doing the huffing technique and the complete yogic breath, if there is some blockage, it should feel a little easier.
Okay.
When it feels easier and you do the third, the anulom vilom, the first part, it should make the passage a little more easy, a little clearer still.
Yes.
And then if you do the Krishna's flute maneuver, it'll help you immensely.
Okay.
So you must do it.
Okay, sure.
Just practice once again so that you are comfortable with it. And if there are any questions, I'm still here to answer you. Adi, amazed at the improvement in the quality of breath?
Yeah, yes, absolutely. And I'm very grateful to you for these last 3 days.
It's nothing.
You know. And you're a great teacher because you provided a huge amount of context, which is very important.
I think it makes a difference because then people have a little more clarity.
Yes.
So they can see deeper. But the important thing is, you know, when people actually experience a better breath and within 3 days, when they start experiencing a markedly improved breath, it's such a wonderful thing. There are people who probably never breathed well, or at least not in their, you know, adult lives, etc. So when they start, you know, being able to breathe better, it's hugely transforming. If they could,
go ahead.
Yeah, if they're able to find the wherewithal to continue with the practices, because the mind comes in the way, it stops us. Thoda kuch, what the mind does is, I know. Once the mind goes into I know mode, then it's not able to go deeper. You know, it's like, okay, my role is done. But then persistence requires something else. Persistence requires that clarity ki it has helped me in this way, which has led to greater breakthroughs or whatever else. Therefore, I must continue with it. This is how some practices become so powerfully established in us, and then they start working to our advantage hugely. That is important, to get that clarity and to continue doing it. I'm sorry, you were saying something.
I had a question about how, in the normal course, first of all, how do we bring this into our daily routine? What's a good time? And secondly, the sequence is the way you have showed us, huh? Yes.
Very good question.
Second day, the complete yogic breath, and third, this.
All these three were shown on different days because there are explanations to be given, so that it becomes part of your clarity and your understanding, and you're able to use it. You can actually do all of them together. It won't take more than 5 to 10 minutes, number one. If you have like a congestion or feel, that there is a little bit of cough, cold, etc., then going through all the three will help you a lot.
Okay.
If you find that you're not really having difficulty, it's not like, you have too much of a cough problem, cough as in the Hindi, K-A-P-H-A, cough. If that problem is not too bad, then jump straight into the Krishna's flute maneuver with the Anulom Vilom.
Okay.
You can jump straight. And if your body is able to handle that and if it's happening beautifully, by all means do it. In fact, you must do 10 cycles of the Krishna's flute maneuver with Anulom Vilom.
Okay.
Itna to minimum daily kar lo aap. If you're doing it daily, chances are you will never come to that stage where there is so much congestion that you're not, that you're having difficulty with this, for which you will need to do the huffing technique and the complete yogic breath. They're all useful in their own ways. But if you continue to do some of it regularly, you may follow this, huffing technique. Do a few rounds of huffing technique if you like. It helps to open up the system.
Helps you to keep it, to remember it. Otherwise, you lose the technique. Yes. So you might as well do three of them at least for a short while and then focus on the third Anulom Vilom with the Krishna.
Absolutely. Yeah. So give that one a little more time. If you can do at least 10 cycles of the Krishna's flute maneuver, it takes a little longer. But if you can do 10 cycles of that, and do it aramse. Don't do it in a rush. Do it aramse. Do the squeezes aramse. Notice the quality of improvement. Notice how your breath improves. If you like, do it twice a day. See, because it's very habit forming. Once you start breathing that, the lighter, the smoother, the easier breath, then you start valuing it. Until you've experienced it, it's just theek hai, hota hoga kuch. But when you've experienced that lighter breath, it feels so beautiful. It feels heady almost. You'll do it. I'm sure you'll do it one day. You'll notice how beautiful it feels then.
No, thank you again. Thanks. This has been really, I'm so glad I signed up for this. And
I'm so glad
I was able to make time for this. That is great. And I think I'll connect with you later and probably take some further steps towards meditation.
Definitely, Addy. In fact, can I make a request to all of you, if you don't mind?
Yep.
If you can make a short testimonial that this is the program you did, and this is how you noticed it improved things, etc., I'll be very grateful.
I will send it to you.
You will? Great. Thank you very much. So, a video testimonial or a written testimonial, whatever works.
Yeah.
Video is very effective, though. When people see, somebody is good looking as you, Addy, I think that makes a big impact. No, you're a good looking guy. Isn't he a good looking guy, Addy? Mere school ka dost hai, but he's a good looking guy, isn't he? Yeah. Great. So if you can make a video testimonial, very great. Otherwise, written bhi chalega, aisi koi baat nahi hai.
Audio to abhi bata sakte hain, sir.
Haan ji.
अभी बता सकते हैं कि जो आपके मतलब इंस्पिरेशन से इंप्रूवमेंट आई एम फीलिंग
हां नहीं अभी तो बता देंगे तो मेरे लिए मुझे अच्छा है बट ये इफ यू मेक अ वीडियो और समथिंग इट इंपैक्ट्स मोर ग्रेट वंडरफुल
आई एम फॉलोइंग लास्ट 2-3 इयर्स
दैट इज राइट ये आपका प्रेम है शिखा जी सो नाइस ऑफ यू राइट Okay, anyone else? Anyone else who thinks they can make a, you know, a testimonial, a video or a written testimonial,
you please so share it with me. You are so kind and supportive.
Sorry?
You are so kind and supportive.
No, no, it's nothing. This is the least I can do. In fact, I'm lucky that I have a chance to help people learn to breathe better. I think I'm blessed. You know, I can do this.
We are grateful for your services.
That's a blessing that my maker has given me, and I absolutely value that. I'm sharing my number once again in case anybody wishes to send a testimonial. It helps. See, what I tell people gets undervalued because I am saying it. I'm an interested party. But when somebody who's participated says or speaks about their experience and how it's made an impact, then it carries greater weight. Thank you very much. It's been very nice working with you guys. And Adi, I'll be looking forward to working with you, continuing to work with you as well.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Vijay.
Hello. Namaste. Thank you.
Thank you, Vijay. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. God bless you. God bless you.
धन्यवाद
नेक्स्ट सेशन कब होगा
इसका वैसे एक सेशन तो अभी दो तीन दिन में होगा उसका टाइमिंग होगा 7 to 8:30 बट उसको हम पब्लिक में शायद आई विल नॉट बी एबल टू ब्रिंग इट बिकॉज समय कम है इट्स स्टार्टिंग डे आफ्टर टुमारो 3-day कोर्स एस व्यासा का जो कलकत्ता का जो उनका है ना वो सेटअप उनके लिए फोकस है बट इफ दे आर एबल टू रीच पीपल एवरीवन इज वेलकम जितने लोग अच्छी सांस ले उतना अच्छा दिस इज माय लिटिल सर्विस टू मैनकाइंड इफ आई कैन कॉल इट दैट तो आप यदि चाहें तो मेरा नंबर मैंने दिया आप उसे मैसेज कर दीजिएगा उसके बारे में मैं आपको इन्फॉर्मेशन भेज दूंगा
सर आपको कुछ सोशल मीडिया है सो दैट वी कैन फॉलो यू
सोशल मीडिया फेसबुक में भी हूँ मैं इंस्टा में हूँ बट इंस्टा में आई एम नॉट वेरी एक्टिव बिकॉज आई राइट अ लॉट इंस्टा इज मोर पिक्टोरियल बट फेसबुक में आई कैन राइट मोर आर्टिकल्स पोस्ट वीडियोस एटसेट्रा इंस्टा में वीडियोस टेंड टू बी शॉर्ट प्लस आर्टिकल्स हैव टू बी वेरी वेरी शॉर्ट सो दैट्स माय प्रॉब्लम
सर फेसबुक में आपका नाम पे हो जाएगा सर राजेश कनोई बोल के
जी जी राजेश कनोई के नाम से है और वो मेरे जो दो तीन ग्रुप्स हैं चार पांच ग्रुप्स हैं ब्रेथ के अलग अलग तरह के ब्रेथ के टेक्निक्स वन इज फॉर
तंत्र ब्रेथ तंत्र
एक हाँ एक ब्रेथ ऑफ लव है वो तंत्र वे ऑफ तंत्र एक है हाँ जी
पावर ऑफ ब्रेथ
हाँ पावर ऑफ ब्रेथ तो वो वेबसाइट है और वो उसका एक वो भी है पेज भी है बट फेसबुक ग्रुप्स आर फॉर fibromyalgia for Hanuman Master Breath for Breath of Love is tarah se karke 4-5 hai us tarah ke breath secrets and breakthroughs 4-5 aap wo aayenge to dekh lenge usme
definitely because sir we are inspiring to take good breath from you we are learning so definitely I would like to follow you
definitely further. Deepashi every person if we can help people to breathe better see everybody focuses so much attention on the food that they eat on the drinks that they drink but nobody focuses on the quality of their breath if one is able to breathe better you know a better breath I often say to breathe better is to live better khane se zyada avashyakta breath ki hoti hai you can live without food you know for 10 days 12 days 15 days maybe But we cannot live without breath even for 5 minutes, usually. Isn't that so? So the quality of breath is very important. If we learn how to breathe better, and if we can help other people also to breathe better, I think that's a wonderful service to mankind.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for your time and attention, and wish you good luck as well. Namaste.
Good night, sir.
Good night. Good night. Good night.